Welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding A War with No Winners written by V.R. Raghavan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the result that the 1965 war has generated and the lessons it had taught to India and to Pakistan and to the world community. This editorial is also about how it is wrong on part of Pakistan and India to gloss over their win in the war of 1965. Now, in order to understand this editorial, in order to understand 1965 war, we can view it from two perspectives. The number one perspective is the myopic view. If we will judge the war of 1965 from the myopic view, it will give us an idea that this war had proved to be indecisive, and in this war there was no clear winner. Now if you are judging it just from the perspective of how this war has proved in solving the intricate issue of Jammu and Kashmir, then this war was not something that we can say or call as decisive. But if we judge it from the perspective, from the holistic perspective of the changes of the lessons that it had taught to India and the lessons it had imbibed out of this war, then this war had certainly proved to be quite decisive. Now first of all, we will be knowing about how this war had actually proved to be quite decisive and how this war had helped India to really transform itself. The foremost transformation that this war had done to India was about the restructuring of our intelligence realm. Now before this war, our intelligence realm was in a state of quandary. It was in a state of fissiparousness. We were having a dismantled kind of a structure as far as intelligence was concerned. Now after our failure in the war with China in 1962, we were trying to restructure our intelligence network, but that was not strengthened, that was not entrenched properly. It was this war that has helped us to entrench and strengthen and firm up our intelligence network. This entire thing related to research and analysis wing and its attachment to the cabinet, central cabinet, cabinet secretariat, it was done because of this war. So thus entire structure of intelligence that we are having today, we owe it to this 1965 war. And it was this very structure that has helped India to win up a war against Pakistan in 1971. It was this lesson that the India had learned from this war had helped us to provide support in the creation of Bangladesh. Had this lesson been not learned, India would not have been able to provide succor to Bangladesh. Now the another lesson that this war had taught to India, and how this war not just proving India to be a winner but helping India to learn another lesson, that was in the domain of making India a deterrent power in the domain of nuclear. Now it was this war that had helped India to adopt the path of nuclear energy. It was this war because of which we had conducted nuclear tests in Pokhran. It was because of this test, because of this war, we had got a decisive leader. We had got a leader which was more firm. That is Indira Gandhi. Before Indira Gandhi, we were having a leader, Lal Bahadur Shastri, who was actually not firm, who was actually more placid, who was actually more flexible. who was actually less indefatigable. He was actually less ingenuous in comparison to Jawaharlal Nehru and in comparison to Indira Gandhi. It was because of this war we have been able to create more distinct and firm diplomatic strategy. And it was this war, 1965 war, that had helped India to restructure the entire diplomatic landscape. It was this war that has helped India for the involvement of the foreign countries like United States of America and USSR. Now this war has also helped India to be actually self-sufficient in the domain of food security. Now during this war and before this war, from a period of 1961 till a period of 1965, India was not self-sufficient in the domain of food, and we were actually becoming more and more reliant on the imports that we were doing from United States of America in under a project named New Deal. And after this war, India had decided to institutionalize reform in the agriculture sector. And because of this war, we were able to revolutionize Indian agriculture. Because of this war, we got green revolution in India. Though this war had proved to be indecisive in solving the problem, but this war had proved that India has the capacity of a deterrent power. Even if we are not having the capacity and the capability to conduct an attack, we are not having the capacity and the capability to take over Pakistan or to take over China. But yes, certainly it has taught India that it can prove to be a deterrent power. India had shown its deterrency to the entire world by thwarting this attack that Pakistan had done under a covert and overt operation that is generally called as Operation Gibraltar. So if we are judging it only from one perspective, we will not get the holistic picture. So we actually need to judge it from a holistic perspective, from multiple dimensions, not only from the dimension of whether it had proved in solving our intricate problem with Pakistan with respect to Srinagar, but the need is to judge it from the holistic perspective. And the BJP government, what it is doing, this NDA government, is trying to put itself on the path of pomp and show by conducting celebrations of the 50th year of win of this war. That is actually not required. What is more required is the restructuring of the entire foreign policy realm. We need to restructure our entire foreign services. We need to restructure our external affairs ministry so that we can be more proactive. We need to restructure intelligence. So those things are more important. The pomp and show is not that important. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you have liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.